Yeah, our first interfacing experiment is keyboard and 7-segment display interfacing using our FPGA board. So in that we have to first learn about two elements. One is a keyboard, the other one is 7-segment display. So first we will see what is a 7-segment display. This is the structure of the 7-segment display. We have 7 segments. The segments are A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H. Out of this we will be using the first 6 segments A to G for giving the inputs. So we will take a variable DSP. DSP is of 7 bits A, B, C, D, E, F, G. This is how we declare it, 6 down to 0 DSP. So say you want to display the letters 0. For that you have to, this is how the digit 0 will be displayed. So A, B, C, D, E, F except G, all the other elements should be given a 1. Similarly, for displaying 1, you have to activate the elements, the segments B and C. So only B and C will be given 1, all other segments will be given 0. The same way we can write for 2, 3 up to F. So that is about 7-segment display. And in our segment, interfacing board, we have such 4 segments. So we need to select any one out of these 4. For choosing one, it is based on active low. So we use another variable called DSPN, and the DSPN will be declared as 3 down to 0 DSPN. If you are assigning the value 4 tick B 1110, it means that the last segment is activated. So this segment will be selected. Okay, that is about our 7-segment display and choosing the display. Now we can see here, in this picture, this is the FPGA board, and to this FPGA board we are interfacing, we are attaching this card. This consists of your keyboard, this is your keypad. The keypads are, it's a 4x4 matrix, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 up to F. And here is your 7-segment display. We have 4 such 7-segment displays. Out of this we have to choose any one. So according to our code, we are choosing the last one. These are the interfacing cables. Okay. Now, the second part of this is about the keyboard. This is the structure of the keyboard as I shown in the picture. We have a 4x4 matrix, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F. Now, we use two variables called scan and read for scanning the keyboard. Now the internal structure of the keyboard is like a push button matrix. C0, this is column 0, the first column, second column, third column, fourth column, these are the different rows. So this is scanned using the scan inputs, and these corresponding rows are read using the read signal. Now when we press the digit 0, what happens is it acts as a closed circuit, and the C0 signal will be connected to R0. So let us say I am sending a signal 1 to scan the first column. And when the first column is scanned, if you are pressing 0, R0 becomes 1. Instead, if you are pressing 4, R1 becomes 1. So according to the different conditions, we decide which element is being pressed, and we will display it in the 7-segment display. So for scanning the different columns, we use something called a scan input, and the scan input should be assigned with signals. So that is done here using a 2-bit count. So the 2-bit count can take values 00, 01, 10, 11. When the count is 00, I am scanning the first column. So for scanning the first column, I have to give 1 here. Now when the count is 01, you are scanning the second column by giving a 1 over the C1 column. Similarly, you are scanning the third column and fourth column. Now the count is given using a set of the fraction of the code here. Always at the positive edge of the clock, you are incrementing the count. So count is a 2-bit vector. It can increment from 00 to 11. Now, actually what is happening here is, when you are scanning 1, when the scan is 4 tick 001, you are scanning the first column, the C0th column, And when you are scanning this, let us say I am pressing the button 0, R0 becomes 1. Or if you are pressing 4, R1 becomes 1. So there are 4 possibilities under one column itself. So that is being assigned to another variable called read for reading the different rows. Now, when the scan is 001, you are in the first column. In the first column, if you are pressing 0, then the read 0 becomes 1. Now, if you are pressing 4, then read 1 becomes 1. If you are pressing 8, then read 2 becomes 1. If you are pressing C, read 4 becomes 1. Now, when read is 40B001, it means that the digit 0 is pressed and you have to display the digit 0. To display that 0, what you need to do is you have to assign DSP as 0. You have to write DSP equal to this value. Similarly, if read is 0010, you have to write DSP equal to the digital code corresponding to 4. This is how the program has to be written. Now, I'll show you the program. In the code, first you have to declare all the variables. This is the module, hex keypad. One input is the clock input. Then you have the read and scan input for scanning the keyboard. Then the outputs are for displaying the 7 segment values and choosing the one display out of the 4 displays. And then you have one always block. In the first always block, for positive edge of clock, count is incremented. Now, the second always block is used for assigning the scan values. So, for each and every count, whenever the count changes, this always block gets activated. When count is 00, you are scanning the first column. When count becomes 01, second column. When count is 10, you are scanning the third column and then the fourth column, and once it reaches 11, the next count automatically goes to 00. So you keep on scanning right from first column, second column, third column, fourth column, and again back to first column, and it goes on. So when you are scanning the first column, when the scan is 40B001, in the first column there can be 4 different cases of read. So this is a nested case statement in the third always block. So for each case of scan, there is another case of read. And when the read is 001, you are displaying 0th bit. When read is 0010, you are displaying the digit 4. When this is 0100, you are displaying digit 8. So and so. And when you go to the second column, when scan becomes 0010, again you have 4 rows in that case. Similarly, when you come to the third column, still you have 4 cases. So correspondingly, all the keys are being scanned, and whichever key is pressed, you are displaying the digit in the 7 segment display. So that is the end of the code. And assign DSP n is equal to this is for choosing the last display. So in the output, what you find is, if you are pressing any one of the keys, the corresponding digit will be displayed in the 7 segment display. And for the interfacing, you have to assign all the pins, all the input output variables with the corresponding pins of the FPGA board. This is the FPGA board, and here is your FPGA IC, and the IC pins are brought out through these ports. And to the corresponding ports, you are connecting through these cables. And this port is for connecting the keypad, and this port is for connecting the 7 segment. So correspondingly, the signals should be assigned with the pins. So what are the pins? For the keyboard, you have scan and read. So scan read should be assigned with some FRC, some port, so that it can be connected, can be sent through this cable. Similarly, for the outputs from the FPGA, which are DSP and DSPN, it should be connected to this port, which is for the 7 segment display. This pin allocation is done with the help of another file called UCF. This UCF is user constraints file. Here is the UCF file, and the pin numbers will be mentioned in the FPGA board itself. So net DSP. DSP consists of 7 bits starting from 0 to 6. This is allocated to these pin numbers of FPGA. And again DSPN. Again you have 4 bits 0 to 3. It is assigned to these pin numbers of the FPGA. And you also have the inputs which are read and scan, 4 bits each. Those should be given to another port. And always clock should be assigned to 55. Pin number 55 is the pin number for giving the clock in the FPGA board. So after that you can dump this code, you can implement the code and then dump the code into the FPGA and run the FPGA. You can your setup will be ready for simulation. Whichever key you press, it will be displayed in the 7-segment board, in the 7-segment display. Okay. Yeah, thank you.